Translation. I wish that all those calamities could happen again and again, so that we can see you again and again. For seeing you means that we will no longer see repeated birth and death.
So, very, very interesting verse that before calamities, danger, that is very good if such danger and calamities remind me of Krishna. That is very good. Tattinu kampa susumikshamana bhunyana ivatma kritam vipakam. A devotee, how he receives dangerous position. Danger must be there. Danger because this place, this material world is full of dangers. These foolish persons, they do not know that. They are trying to avoid the dangers. That is struggle for existence. Everyone is trying to become happy and avoid danger. This is the material business. Atyantika sukham. Atyantik sukh, ultimate happiness. A man is working and thinking, let me work now very hard and let me have some bank balance, so when I shall get old, I shall enjoy life without any working. That is the inner intention of everyone. Nobody wants to work. As soon as he gets some money, he wants to retire from work and to become happy. But that is not possible. You cannot be happy in that way. Here it is said, apunar bhavadarsanam. The real danger is, she is picking up apunar. Apunar means, or means not. And punar bhava means repetition of birth and death. The real danger is, repetition of birth and death, that has to be stopped. And not this so-called danger. This is all, the material world is full of dangers. Padang padang jada vipada. Just like if you are on the ocean. If you are on the ocean, you might have very strong ship, very safe ship. But that is not safety. Because you are on the sea, at any time there can be dangers. But as you remember from your country, there was, what is that, Titanic? Everything was safe, but on the first voyage it was drowned. And all important men of your country, they lost their lives. So danger there must be, because you are in a dangerous position. This material world itself is dangerous position. So our business is, the danger must be there. Our business should be how to cross over the sea as soon as possible. So long you are on the sea, you are on the dangerous position, however strong your ship may be. That's a fact. See, you should not be disturbed by the sea waves. Just try to cross over the sea, go to the other side. That is a business. Similarly, so long we are in this material world, there must be dangerous calamities, because this is the place of calamity. So our business is, even within these calamities, dangers, how we develop our Krishna consciousness, and after giving up this body, we go back to home, back to Krishna. That should be all. We should not be disturbed by the so-called calamities. They are not so-called, they are factual. So, this question was there by Arjuna to Krishna, that whatever you are speaking, it is all right, that I am not this body, I am soul. Everyone is not this body, he is soul. So on the annihilation of this body, on the annihilation of the body, the soul will exist. But when I see my son is dying, or my grandfather is dying, I am killing, how can I solace me that my grandfather is not dying, my son is not dying? Simply it is changing, because I am accustomed to think like that. So there must be grief. So Krishna replied, yes, that's a fact. But that you must have to tolerate, that's all. There is no other way. Tang titikkasa bharat. Krishna never said that these are not facts. What Arjuna explained, that I know that when my son is dying, my son is changing the body, or my grandfather is dying, changing the body, I know this. But still, because I am affectionate on the skin, so I must suffer. The Krishna replied, yes, the suffering is there, because you are also on the bodily concept of life. So suffering must be there. So there is no other remedy than to tolerate. There is no other remedy. Matras parsastu kontiyo sitosno sukhadukkada. Just like in your country, it is very chilly in the morning to take bath, a little difficult task. But does it mean that those who are devotees, they will stop taking bath? No. Even it is chilly, cold, one must take bath. The duty must be done. The duty must be done. Even it is little suffering. That is called tapasya. Tapasya means we must proceed with our Krishna consciousness, business, in spite of all dangerous and calamitous condition of this world. This is called tapasya. Tapasya means voluntarily accepting the difficulties of life. Sometimes tapasya, in the system of tapasya, in hot season, summer, and scorching heat of the sun, still they ignite some fire all down and sit down in the midst and meditate. There are some processes of tapasya like that. In chilly cold, one goes into the water up to the neck and meditate. These things are prescribed in tapasya, but Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu does not give you such prescription. He gives you a very nice program. Chant, dance and take prasad. Still we are unwilling. We cannot accept this tapasya. You see? We are so fallen. Susukham kartumabhyam. This is a kind of tapasya which is very easy to do and it is very pleasant. Still we are not agreeable. We shall rot in the street, lie down anywhere and everywhere, and still I shall drink and have sex and lie down. So what can be done? We are giving good facilities. Come here, chant, dance, and live very peacefully and take Krishna prasad, be happy, but people will not accept. That is called misfortune. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu therefore said, itadrishi tava kripa bhagavan mamapi. Duddhaiva idrisham iha janina anuragam. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says, Nam namakari bahudha nijasadva shakti. In the transcendental holy name of God, Krishna, there is all potencies. As Krishna has got unlimited potencies, similarly, in the name, holy name of Krishna, there is unlimited potency. So, Nam Namakari Bhuda, and there are many names of Krishna. Krishna has got thousands and thousands of names. Krishna name is the chief name. Nam Namakari Bhuda Nijasarva Shakti Tatrapita Niyamita Smarani Nukala. And there is no hard and fast rule that you have to chant in this time or that time. No. Any time. Any time you can take. And the name is identical with Krishna. On this logic, the name, holy name of Krishna, is Krishna. It's no other than Krishna. Don't think that Krishna is living in Goloka Vrindavan and the name is different. Just like in material world we have got this conception. The name is different from the fact. But in absolute world, there is no such difference. That is called absolute. The name is as potential as Krishna is potential. So, you have got this tongue, you can chant Krishna, Hare Krishna. Immediately you become directly in touch with Krishna. Immediately. Because the name Krishna and Krishna person is not different, identical. Even if you think that Krishna is far, far away, Krishna is not far, far away. Krishna is within you. He's not far away. He's far away, at the same time nearest. So, even if you think that Krishna is far, far, his name is there. You chant Hare Krishna, Krishna becomes immediately available. And Niyamitas, and for making Krishna available in the shortcut way, there is no hard and fast rule. You can chant any time. Immediately you get Krishna. Just see the mercy of Krishna. Therefore, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says that etadisi tava kripa, my dear Lord, you have given me so nice facilities to contact you. But duddhaiva, I am so unfortunate. I have no attachment for this thing. I have no attachment. I have got so many attachments for other things. But I have no attachment for chanting Hare Krishna. This is my misfortune. Krishna has given so much facilities that he is present before you by transcendental vibration in his name. And the name has got all the potencies of Krishna. So if you remain in contact with the name, you get all the benefit of Krishna's benediction. But still, I am not inclined to chant Hare Krishna. This is misfortune. So, a devotee never takes dangerous position as very reverse position or very calamitous position. He welcomes. Because a surrendered soul, he knows either danger or festival. These are all different demonstration of Krishna. Krishna is absolute. In its shastra it is said, just like there are two kinds, two sides, religiosity and irreligiosity. Just the opposite. But in the shastra it is said, the religiosity is just the front portion of God. And irreligiosity is the back portion of God. So, God's front portion or back portion, is there any difference? God is absolute. Therefore, a devotee, either in opulence or in danger, he is not disturbed. He knows both these things are Krishna. Either in dangerous position. Now Krishna has appeared before me as danger. Just like Hiranyakashipu and Prahlad Maharaj and Nrisimhadev. Nrisimhadev is dangerous to Hiranyakashipu. And he is the supreme friend to Prahlad Maharaj, the same personality. Similarly, God is never dangerous to the devotee. Devotee is never afraid of danger. He is confident that the danger is that is another feature of God. So why shall I be afraid? I am surrendered to him. So Kunti Devi says that Vipada Santu, Vipada Santu Ta Sasat, because she knows how to remember Krishna at times of danger. She is welcoming danger. My dear Lord, I welcome such dangers when I can remember you. Just like Prahlad Maharaj, he was always thinking of Krishna when his father was putting him in dangerous position. So, if you are put into the dangerous position, and if that dangerous position gives an impetus to remember Krishna, that is welcome. That is welcome. Oh, I am getting this opportunity of remembering Krishna. So how it is welcome? It is welcome because seeing Krishna means I am advancing in my spiritual life so that I will not have to suffer any more of this dangerous position. Taktadihaṁ punarjanmanaiti māmi tui kuntiya. If you become advanced in Krishna consciousness, then the result will be, after giving up this body, Krishna says, taktadihaṁ, after giving up this body, punarjanmanaiti, you don't take birth again in this material world. That is wanted. Suppose I am very comfortable at the present moment. My body is kept in a very comfortable position. But there is death and there is another birth. So after giving up this body, if I get the body of a cat and dog, then what is the meaning of this comfortable position? Because death is sure. And janmantram, tatha dehantram. Dehantram means you have to accept another body. If you do not know what kind of body you are going to get, you can know it. That is stated in the Shastra, that if you have got such and such mentality, you get such and such body. So, in a comfortable position, if I keep myself in the dog's mentality, then I am going to get my next life as dog, then what is the value of this comfortable position? I may be in comfortable position for 20 years, 50 years, or at most 100 years. And after that comfortable position, when I give up this body, if due to my mentality I become a cat and dog and mouse, then what is the benefit of this comfortable position? These people, they do not know that. They think, especially in this age, that I am now in comfortable position. I have got enough money, I have got enough state, I have enough comforts, enough food. So, as soon as the body is finished, so I am not going to take birth again. So long I am living, let me enjoy life. This is the modern philosophy, hedonism. But that is not the fact. Kunti is therefore anxious, apunar bhava darsanam. Apunar bhava. Not to repeat. If you see always Krishna, that is Krishna consciousness. Krishna consciousness means always thinking of Krishna. Your consciousness should be absorbed in Krishna thought. Therefore, we give different varieties of engagement, Krishna consciousness. We should not divert our energy. Now when we are selling bhog, that is Krishna consciousness, we are selling bhog. But if we think that the selling bhog may be diverted into selling jewelry, that is not very good idea. That is not very good idea. Then we become again jeweler. Pulan Moshika Bhava, again become mouse. We should be very much careful. Our Krishna consciousness cannot be diverted, then you are gone to hell. Even there is danger, even there is suffering in Krishna consciousness, we should tolerate. That is the instruction. We should welcome that danger and pray to Krishna. What is that prayer? Tatte nukampa susumikshaman. My dear Lord, it is your great mercy that I am put into this dangerous position. And that is the viewpoint of devotee. He doesn't take danger as danger. He takes, it is Krishna's mercy. What kind of mercy? Bhunyana evatma kritam vipakam. Due to my past activities, I was to suffer so much, but you are mitigating that suffering, giving me little suffering. Just like a token punishment. Sometimes in the court, a big man is culprit. So if the judge wants $100,000, he can pay immediately. But he asks for me, you just give 1 cent. Because that is also punishment, but minimize it. Similarly, we have to suffer on account of our past deeds. That's a fact. You cannot avoid. Karmani nidhati kintu cha bhakti vaja. But those who are in devotional service, those who are in Krishna consciousness, their sufferings are minimized. A token. Just like one wants to be killed. See, instead of being killed with his knife, he gets some little cut. In this way, karmani nidhati kintu cha bhakti, those who are in devotional service, there, ahantang sarva pape bhomokkhoishyami. Krishna assures that I give you protection from the reaction of sinful life. So, when there is very, very grievous criminal activities behind this, sometimes it is like that. Instead of hanging him, there may be a little cut by the knife on the finger. This is the position. So why should we be afraid of danger? We should simply depend on Krishna consciousness. Because if we leave Krishna consciousness in any circumstances, then my benefit is that I am not coming again in this material. Apunar bhava darsana. The repeatedly as you think of Krishna, as you see Krishna, as you read of Krishna, as you work for Krishna, somewhere or other, if you remain in Krishna consciousness, that is your benefit. And that benefit will save you from taking birth again in this material world. And that is real benefit. And if I am become little comfortable by so-called other engagement, and if I forget Krishna and I have to take birth again, then what is my benefit? We should be very much careful about this. Krishna consciousness cannot be disturbed at any circumstances. Even there is heavy suffering. That is the instruction of Kunti Devi. Kunti Devi is welcoming. Vipada santu ta tatrata. Like that. Because before winning the battle of Kurukshetra, all these Pandavas were put into so many dangerous positions, that is already described in the previous verses. Sometimes they are offered poison, sometimes they are put into the house, lack, and it was set fire. Sometimes big demons, man-eaters and big fighters. Every time they lost their kingdom, lost their wife, lost their prestige, they were put into the forest, full of dangers. But within all those dangers, Krishna was there. With all those dangers. When the Draupadi was being naked, Krishna was there supplying cloth. Krishna was always there. Therefore, Bhishma Dev, while he was dying, He was grandfather of the Pandavas. So when the Pandavas came to see him on his deathbed, so he cried that these boys, my grandsons, they're all very pious. Maharaj Yudhishthira, the topmost pious person, his name is Dharmaraj, the king of religiosity. He is the eldest brother. And Bhim and Arjun, they are devotees and so great hero. They can kill thousands of men. They are so powerful. Yudhishthira is there. And Bhima is there. Arjuna is there. And Draupadi is directly the goddess of fortune. There was this injunction that wherever Draupadi will be there, there will be no scarcity of food. In this way, the combination was so nice. And over and above them, Krishna is always with them. And still they are suffering. So he began to cry. I do not know what is the arrangement of Krishna. But such pious men, such devotees, they are also suffering. So, don't think that because I have become a devotee, there will be no danger, no suffering. And Prahlad Maharaj suffered so much, the Pandavas suffered so much, Haridas Thakur suffered so much. But we should not be disturbed by those suffering. We must have firm faith, firm conviction that Krishna is there. He will give me protection. Kauntya pratijanihi name bhakta pranasyati. Don't try to take benefit of other shelter than Krishna. Always stick to Krishna. Krishna says, Kauntya pratijanihi name bhakta pranasyati. My dear Arjuna, you can declare it to the public that my devotees are never vanquished. Why declaration was advised to be made by Arjuna? Why he did not declare himself? There is some point. Because this declaration, if Krishna makes, there may be violation, because sometimes he violated his promise. But if his devotee promises, it will be never violated. That is Krishna's business. Oh, my devotee has declared this. I must see that it must be executed. That is Krishna's position. He is so much attached to his devotee. Therefore he said that you declare. If I declare, people may not believe it. But if you declare, they will believe it. Because you are devotee. Your declaration will never be. Jasya prasadat bhagavat prasad. Krishna wants to see that my devotee's promise is fulfilled. My promise may not be fulfilled, may be broken. So this is Krishna consciousness. We must stick to Krishna consciousness in all circumstances, even in the most dangerous position. We must keep our faith in Krishna's lotus feet, and there will be no danger. Thank you very much.